A wolf closing in on its prey. That's how a then 25-year-old female Trump White House worker described Rudy Giuliani sexually assaulting her. Yep, just when things couldn't get any worse for Rudy Giuliani, a top White House staffer now accuses Rudy Giuliani, America's mayor, of molesting her on January 6. Her name is Cassidy Hutchinson, and if you watched any of the January 6 hearings last year, you would know she's an American hero, truly an American hero. Hutchinson worked for Trump's White House chief of staff, Mark Meadows. She was called to testify before the January 6 committee last year. And so, as he often does, Donald Trump provided her with free legal counsel, an attorney named Stefan Pasentino, who served as the top ethics attorney inside the Trump White House. Well, after he left the Trump White House, he was on retainer with Trump's Save America PAC, and he provided free legal counsel to people like Cassidy Hutchinson when they were called before the committee. Remember, this guy's name is Stefan Pasentino, and when Trump was in the White House, Stefan Pasentino was one of Trump's top ethics attorneys inside the White House. Okay, now it's last year, Biden's president, Stefan Pasentino, is providing free legal advice, counsel to people like Cassidy Hutchinson when she's called before the January 6th committee. And he started giving her advice for free, and Cassidy Hutchinson said, you know what, I'm going to need a different lawyer. According to Cassidy Hutchinson, Pasentino, remember he is the ethics counsel in the White House when Trump was there, Pasentino, according to Cassidy Hutchinson, told her to tell the January 6th committee that she didn't recall certain things. And then Pasentino, according to Cassidy Hutchinson, Pasentino suggested that there would be lucrative jobs in quote-unquote Trump world if she played ball. Cassidy Hutchinson said, you know what, I better get a different attorney. And she became one of the star witnesses during the January 6 hearings who implicated her boss, Mark Meadows. She implicated Donald Trump. And of course, Rudy Giuliani, who she now accuses in her new book of assaulting her backstage on January 6. Now, if you recall, Rudy Giuliani and attorney John Eastman, both of whom are co-defendants down in Fulton County as part of that racketeering trial. John Eastman was the attorney who wrote the memos outlining why Mike Pence could decertify the election, and he wrote the memos organizing the false elector scheme. Well, Rudy Giuliani and attorney John Eastman both spoke on the Ellipse on January 6, warming up the heavily armed crowd for the big Stop the Steal rally. They warmed up the crowd for Donald Trump, who then took the stage and urged his armed supporters to storm the Capitol. Now, Cassidy Hutchinson was Mark Meadows' assistant at the time. She was there backstage, and she writes in her new book that after Eastman and Giuliani spoke, they were all backstage in a white tent where Giuliani, quote, put his hand under my blazer, then my skirt. She said while this assault was going on, the attorney John Eastman watched and then flashed a leering grin. She writes of Rudy Giuliani's sexual assault, quote, I feel his frozen fingers trail up my thigh. He tilts his chin up. The whites of his eyes look jaundiced. My eyes dart to John Eastman, who flashes a leering grin. Cassidy Hutchinson goes on to write, I fight against the tension in my muscles and recoil from Rudy's grip, filled with rage. Rudy Giuliani is currently facing a $10 million lawsuit from a former female employee who accuses him of both wage theft and rape. Meanwhile, Rudy Giuliani was told on Wednesday that a trial date has been set to determine how much he must pay Fulton County election workers Ruby Freeman and Wandrea Shea Moss. If you remember, Giuliani lost their defamation lawsuit when he refused to turn over documents during the discovery phase of the trial. So he's lost that case. The judge in the trial has set December 11th as the date Rudy will go before a jury to determine how much he must pay this mother and daughter for the damages he caused in their life by spreading lies about them, feeding Biden ballots into the machines, which they weren't doing. Earlier this week, Rudy was sued by one of his attorneys for nearly $1.4 million in unpaid legal fees.